Hey guys, it's Marianne. Welcome back to Handmade. And if you guys have watched this channel long enough, you probably know by now that we will paint anything. We'll paint anything that sits still long enough, really. Actually, we'll only paint things that sit still. I don't really recommend painting living, moving objects, but I digress. We will put a coat of paint on just about anything. And it's no secret that one of our favorite finishes is a matte, you know, ceramic-like kind of chalky finish of paint. Now, we all have our favorite brands of paint, but there are a million hacks out there to try and make your own. So I got kind of curious, like, are these any good? Do they actually measure up to the kind you can buy in the store? So today I'm gonna test out three recipes for ceramic matte chalky paint and see which one works the best. And then, well, I'm gonna have a lot of paint, so I'm gonna have to figure out something to paint after that. You know guys, it's a journey. You never know what you're gonna get in a video with me, so let's get started. Okay, so before we dive in, we're gonna talk a little bit about the materials. So the three most popular techniques to make your own matte chalky finish paint all use latex house paint as the base. They all use this because it's water-based, so you can thin it with water and get the, you know, opacity that you're looking for. So I just have a sample of some house paint right here. And then, again, the three most popular techniques called for either baking powder, plaster of Paris, or calcium carbonate. This is the same kind of calcium that you can take as a supplement. I ordered the plaster of Paris and the calcium carbonate online, pulled the baking powder right out of my baking drawer. So I think I'm gonna start with the calcium carbonate. Okay, so I originally grabbed some big plastic bowls, but I actually think I'm gonna do this in some disposable plastic cups. I think it'll be easier to mix a small amount of paint, and I just really don't want to waste a bunch of paint. So we're going to start with our latex paint, and I'm gonna do about a quarter cup of paint. You may wanna grab some paint stirring sticks, something like that. Into our paint, we're going to stir 2 tablespoons of our calcium carbonate. I ordered this online. You can get it, you know, at like a health store. It's often sold as like a vitamin supplement that you can use to increase your calcium intake. And now we're just going to add a little bit of water. The amount of water is really dependent on how thin you want your paint to be. You know, if you're going for more of like a whitewashed look versus, you know, a really opaque look. And we're just gonna stir that really well. And because I wanna be completely fair, I'm gonna go ahead and paint a test swatch of this paint now before I get started on the other two so that no paint, you know, sat around longer than any of the others. I'm gonna grab a clean foam paintbrush and we are just going to paint a swatch right here. And what we'll be comparing is opacity, finish, and how well did it stick onto this unprimed wood. So I'm just going to write down here, calcium. That's one down. Let's move on to the next. All right, up next, we are going to try our baking powder. Powder, not soda. I'm gonna do about the same amount of paint, about a quarter cup. And we're going to do a teaspoon of the baking powder. And these don't call for adding any water, so we're just gonna stir that right in. This is definitely gonna be a thicker consistency. Whoa, it is making it, whoa. think we need to add a little water. I'm not sure what is happening, but it's just solidifying and becoming like foamy. Do you guys see that? I'm gonna try adding a little bit more water, but wow, that is unexpected. I mean, this is a texture unlike anything I have ever seen before. But you know, in the name of science, we are going to put some on the board. There's our calcium. All right, grabbing a new foam-tipped paintbrush. It really feels like just the water is what's sticking. I just tried to like, oh, this is so weird. I just tried to like scoop some up. I don't think this worked, but we're just gonna let it dry. Imagine what could happen in the drying process to make that not look like baby puke, but you know, it's a scientific process, guys. All right, and last but not least, we are trying plaster of Paris. This technique is slightly different from the other two. We mix the plaster of Paris with water first before adding our paint. So we are going to do about 2.5 tablespoons plaster of Paris and an equal amount of room temperature water. Grab a stir stick and mix that up. And now add about 1/2 cup of paint. And it's nowhere near as like chunky and weird as the baking powder was, but this definitely got a lot thicker. Might need a little more water. These keep getting super thick. But that's looking good. All right, bring in the board. One more clean foam paintbrush and brush this on. I'm giving all of these a pretty thick coat because I also want to see how they do in terms of like self-leveling. All right. Hey, we're just going to let these dry completely and then we'll come back for the final verdict. All right, so here we are, day two, because we've learned anything during this time, it's that I am apparently incapable of shooting anything in one day. I let these dry overnight, and so now we can see the final results. So the calcium powder honestly has like the least amount of chalky texture. It also had the lightest coverage, but it is the smoothest. So, you know, this could be an option for you if you just want like a very subtle amount of like a matte ceramic finish, but you're definitely gonna need 2 or 3 coats. The baking powder, this stuff looks disgusting. It feels worse. I will say, I thought all of this texture would like come off on your hands or flake off, and it's on there. So that's good. I cannot think of an application where you would want to use this. This just has a terrible texture. It's seriously giving me like the heebie-jeebies. And then lastly, we have plaster of Paris. This one I think is the closest to like a classic chalky paint finish. It's a little streaky, it's a little textury. To be honest, it's nowhere near as like nice quality as a chalk finish paint that you would buy at the store. However, I think if you watered it down a bit more, it would be a really pretty kind of, you know, whitewashed effect. So that was our big paint experiment. And now I have leftover paint. This is the plaster of Paris. This is the baking soda paint. It's getting thrown away. And this is the calcium paint. And I hate to waste paint, you know, guys? If only I had something I could paint. Something seasonal, out of nowhere? It must be fall. Yes, if you're wondering, this is a completely normal amount of faux pumpkins to have. Okay, this is a lot of pumpkins. Guys, I work for HGTV. What can I tell you? We're in the seasonal gourd business over here. Let's move some of these bigger guys out of the way. she's thick. I think I'm gonna start with a small one. So, why do I wanna whitewash these pumpkins? Well, honestly, I love those fairy tale pumpkins that you can find at the store. They're like very whitewashed looking naturally. They're these beautiful kind of like earthen terracotta shades. And I feel like if I dilute some of our paint here and paint them on an orange pumpkin, I might get a similar vibe. Maybe I will hate it. Maybe I'll end up repainting these orange. Let's find out. If you're wondering if I tested any of this ahead of time, I did not. What could go wrong? All right, so I saved my paint and it's pretty chunky on the bottom, so I'm gonna give it a good stir. Ooh, she's really chunky. In fact, I might even start with a really tiny one to like get the thickness of the paint right before, you know, I move on to like the big boys. All right, so I'm gonna try it as is. I'm not going to thin it anymore yet. And just grabbing, you know, another foam-tipped paintbrush and let's just see what happens, shall we? The texture is a little like gritty. It is making that really, you know, aggressive orange. It is toning it down. I'm also going to try the calcium paint. I'm not trying the baking powder paint. I threw that away. I know that chalk paint can be pricey and I was really hoping to like give you guys a great hack for making your own, but I used a lot of chalk paint in my days and this is not as good. It also, I think because it's so textured, it's really showing brush strokes. So I'm just trying to like smooth that out. And that's funny because one of the things I love about chalk paint is like it's self-leveling and it doesn't show brush strokes. It just makes it like really easy to work with. And this, I'm just having to be very careful. But you know, it looks cute. So we're gonna set that guy aside. All right, and now I'm going to grab the paint with the calcium in it. Give it a stir. Now, unlike the plaster of Paris, this seems completely the same. Like it doesn't seem like anything settled, no chunks or anything. I think I'm gonna add a little water to this one because I really want, you know, a very like sheer color. All right, I think I'm gonna grab this bigger one, another clean paintbrush. I should have like stock in foam paintbrushes at this point. And let's see how this one works. So right away, I can see that this is more opaque than I want. So hold that thought. I'm gonna grab, actually, yeah, I'm gonna grab a rag. All right, so I just grabbed a rag and I'm going to kind of wipe the paint off, almost like we're staining something. I think that looks so pretty. Okay, I can work with this. We're really getting just like a wash of the paint. It's kind of what I had hoped to accomplish by diluting it. But this method, honestly, works better. Put on a coat and then just wipe it off until you get the desired effect. And that is exactly what I was going for. This calcium paint, it's just really not very matte. I don't know if the calcium did anything. I think this is just diluted paint. But now you know. I want to debunk more craft myths. This is working really well though. And it's kind of like foolproof. It's pretty. I like this color so much more than the original orange. All right, that's kind of what I'm talking about. Really pleased with how that one's looking. I'm gonna set it aside and let it dry completely. And then I'm gonna turn this rag inside out and paint some more. I'm really curious to see how this works on one of these green pumpkins. So I think that could be really pretty. So there's only one way to find out, right guys? So just like on the orange one, I'm just kind of slapping the paint on and then I'm gonna wipe it off. So pretty, getting like serious farmhouse vibes, serious fall vibes. If you guys have been watching this channel long enough, you know I don't really love fall, but this year I'm trying to embrace it because I don't need any more negativity in my life. That's so pretty. I cannot wait to see what this looks like when it dries. Speaking of drying, I have to say, I might be changing my stance and declaring the calcium the winner of this particular race. That's like a beautiful, matte, whitewashed farmhouse perfection. Well guys, we really went on a journey here today, didn't we? Tried a bunch of chalk paint hacks, learned that most of them don't really work, but then whitewashed a bunch of pumpkins. I mean, guys, I'm almost excited about fall and that never happens. But I wanna hear from you guys. Do you want us to test more of these hacks to see if they work? Cause it's kind of fun. And you know, what's your favorite part of fall? Do you like the pumpkins? I do like the pumpkins. Also, should we give this pumpkin a name? Leave me a comment down below with what you would name this giant pumpkin and tell me if you think I should paint it or not. I mean, it's so pretty, but if you guys still want to paint it, I'll paint it. Maybe I will go live and paint it. We could have a little pumpkin painting party. Hit me up in the comments down below, pumpkin name, whether you think I should paint this bad boy, and I will see you guys.